News on KDKA-TV. It's a sellout crowd here at the Bradley Center for a second-round matchup. The winner advancing to the East Rutherford region to meet Oklahoma State. The number three seed, Pittsburgh Panthers, with all 30 wins of theirs against sixth-seeded Wisconsin. There you see the starting lineup sponsored by Pontiac. And clearly the anchor is Carl Krauser in the backcourt. And for the Badgers, Devin Harris, the do-everything guard for Bo Ryan in his third year, just a few years removed from Division III coaching at Wisconsin-Blacksville. And on the other side, the boyish good looks of the 38-year-old Jamie Dixon, who once did television commercials at the age of five in North Hollywood. New officials for today's game, Tim Higgins, Tom O'Neill, Frank Scagliata, G-Man. This is clearly a game that will have a magnificent impact from its crowd.
Two very, very good defensive teams, Tim, and some physical specimens out on the floor, a lot of banging inside.
Wilkinson, almost a point forward at times for the Badgers. Blue Wade had a tremendous game the other night in that 19-possession comeback. Wisconsin was down early. He was the anchor to keep them in the game. Mader, the turnaround on the baseline. Krauser, the rebound for Pittsburgh.
Tapp, very much a shot-blocking threat in the middle for Pitt, able to challenge that jump shot.
Pittsburgh got here by virtue of a grinded-out win over a feisty team from Central Florida, and the Badgers had to come from 13 down in the second half to knock out Jerry Wainwright's Richmond Spiders. Wilkinson, the near steal. Loose ball, and it's taken away by Boo Wade. Little too much on that pass. Devin Harris tried to save it as he went into the percussion section over there.
Wisconsin normally very deliberate offensively. However, they will run on long misses and turnovers, and that's the one time you'll see Devin Harris out in the open floor.
So much at stake for these two coaches, one a veteran and one very young. Just underway here in Pittsburgh, defense the order of the day. As Boo Wade knocks it away. Two teams that many consider Final Four candidates. And in fact, when you look at the records of both teams, Jamie Dixon's team already with 30 wins and a Big East regular season title at the very least, this could be considered a regional final. Krauser, rebound taken down by Mader, the senior from Appleton, Wisconsin.
And not just this year, Tim, but you think about what these programs have done over the last 3 years combined on a national level. The magnitude of this game, incredible. 55 combined wins out there on the floor.
Best in the last 3 years. You think of the record of this Pittsburgh team. It began with Ben Howland. And Wisconsin, the best Big Ten team in the last couple of years. Very consistent, a Sweet 16 member a year ago. We're taken out by Kentucky as they came from 13 down in the second round last year in Spokane to beat the Golden Hurricane. Krauser finds a seam, took an extra step.
Carl Krauser will be aggressive off the dribble, getting into the lane.
And a reminder, those of you expecting to see Kentucky and the Blazers of UAB will be getting you out to your tip shortly.
Well, Tim, I think the other day, Krauser had 13 field goal attempts and only one assist. Jamie Dixon would like to see a little more floor leadership.
Wilkinson, the big fella from Blue Mound, Wisconsin, and Wisconsin Heights High School.
Shooting at 50% on the year, has got beautiful form for a big player. Wisconsin will have their bigs out on the perimeter. They can all shoot, and they can all put it on the deck.
Ron Brown, so very physical. Ball was deflected. Excellent defense by the Badgers inside. Talking about Wilkinson, he has his hands full today with the freshman Chris Taft. Krauser.
Krauser able to turn the corner quickly off the dribble. Made her a little late getting out.
Wilkinson always looking for the cutter when he's up high. Freddie Owens, who means so much to this team with his wing jump shot, brings a lot of athleticism to this Wisconsin club.
A
duck under. Rejected but fouled by Tad. Freshman from Coney Island, who, according to Mike Wilkinson, says he just always gets his hands on the ball. He gets a finger or two. That's one of the reasons Chris Taft is, from a defensive standpoint, both in rebounding and in deflections, can do a lot of things. Nader gets one of them, and it's 3-2 Wisconsin. Three and a half minutes gone by, the Badgers by one. Taft, ball fake, doesn't get the roll. Krauser and Harris tied up, and Tom O'Neill spots a foul. It'll go against Devin Harris.
I think Chris Taft wants to be a little more aggressive offensively in this game. Really was slow to get into the UCF game offensively. And how many times do you see a point guard getting down on the offensive glass? Krauser getting it. There's a guy, Tim, they desperately need to get off. Julius Page has been struggling mightily from the floor over his last six games. 13 of 56.
Harris off the curl, giving it up. Wade. Wave it off. Foul will be spotted inside against the Badgers. Goes against Wilkinson, his first. All points are on a premium with these two defensive teams.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's basketball championship is sponsored by Coca-Cola, Microsoft, Allstate, and by Toyota.
Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, and Heather Cox. Your thoughts, Mike, on what both coaches need to accomplish today to be effective.
For Pitt, they've got to get good ball pressure to disrupt Wisconsin's rhythm, Tim. Wisconsin needs to match the physical play of Pitt up front. I think the X factor for both teams, who can manufacture the most easy baskets?
Wisconsin certainly can catch fire, and that run they had in the second half against Richmond was nothing short of incredible. In fact, there have been comparisons to the Villanova performance against Georgetown in the championship game 19 years ago when they were so efficient.
19, the key number. 19 consecutive possessions they scored 51 points in the second half.
Lou Wade picked up the foul, his first. One field goal apiece on 9 tries collectively in this game for both teams. Pittsburgh with such senior leadership. You think of Jerron Brown, Page, Morris, 136, 135, 130 games. And yet, this is really Carl Krauser's team, the sophomore from the Bronx, New York. Page off the curl, can't get it to go.
He talked yesterday about the fact that he thinks he's getting good looks at the basket, but just rushing his shot. And that's the tendency when you're in a little bit of a slump. You just do things in too much of a hurry. You need to actually slow down.
20% in his last 9 games for Julius Page, and hasn't been able to scratch from deep. 0% from 3. Nader, too strong.
Taft, a nice job staying down in the pump fakes that time.
Page, he did hit 1-3 the other night, kept that string alive of consecutive 3. Fouled underneath. You see the flash that time by Siobhan Trotman. How about the D?
It's a story. I mean, look at the numbers there, Tim. 4th and 2nd in opponents scoring 56, just around 56 points a game. So they gave up in the first round, Pittsburgh 44%, and you're sitting 14-30, yeah. 3-2 in the bottom of the second.
Yeah. In a game that one would expect would be low scoring, but the action has been frenetic.
Two teams that are just committed to very sound, fundamental defensive principles.
Clayton Hansen and Zach Morley, who played strong contributing roles in that come-from-behind win against Richmond, check into the game. Nader and Freddie Owens sit down for the Badgers. Wisconsin is a deeper team than Pitt. Hanson hit two big three-pointers in that run. Number 13 in Badger Red.
About depth in with the pace of this game, I don't think that is going to be an issue. Pitch shouldn't be challenged unless they have foul trouble.
Wilkinson, quality find from Harris. Krauser with the slap away, and the foul will go against Zach Morley on the reach. And Krauser already all over the glass. He has 5 rebounds.
Averages that on the year, but we talked about it. He is a very powerfully built point guard.
6 minutes gone by, only 7 points scored. Page, using the glass, simply cannot buy a bucket.
And a better idea, at least he tried to go inside to get himself untracked offensively.
Morley on the wing. That's what he can deliver. Maryville, Missouri, his home. A little show me in his game. Wisconsin by 2, and much of this crowd now rising to its attention.
It's a very much more athletic Wisconsin team when Morley is in there and Nader is out.
Tapped off the bounce against Wilkinson. Krauser, another offensive rebound, but he traveled as he hit the deck. Tough break for Carl.
Gets up a bit gingerly, should be all right.
Devin Harris once again early in this game playing the role of distributor. Pittsburgh is going to have to honor that shot, and Jamie Dixon is comfortable that his big players can go out on the floor and guard Wisconsin's jump shooters.
Jamie have played at TCU, had a professional career that came to an end at the age of 25. Was first spotted by Ben Howland when he was an assistant to Jerry Penn at Cal Santa Barbara while recruiting him out of high school in North Hollywood. Morley. Oh, Pitt Panthers recognize after that three that they're going to stay a little closer to him.
And McCarroll's long enough that he can get out there and guard.
Harris the runner. Brown gets the rebound for Pittsburgh. Harris with a pick. Krauser and Page finally come up with it.
Here's that stop-and-go maneuver by Krauser. So difficult to guard. Here he is for 3. Too strong. Morley the rebound.
Harris off the bounce.
Aggressive maneuver by Harris that time. Really didn't have rebounding numbers. He felt like he needed to get himself involved offensively.
I know we're 79 miles from Madison, but you can't tell me it doesn't sound like Madison right now.
Now the Pitt players were very upfront about that. The men step up. We're going to have to win a road game.
Ron Brown with another offensive board. One thing about Pittsburgh, even when they're struggling offensively, as they did the other night and have so far in the opening half, they can always anchor themselves on that quality defense. Krauser again finds an avenue. Inside to Trotman, and Siobhan misses with the jump hook.
Those are the opportunities that you have to take advantage of, only because the defense is so stingy. When you get an opportunity to look like that, you've got to knock it down.
Pittsburgh is 1 of 11 from the floor. There's a steal by Siobhan. Trotman gives it up to Jerron Brown. Again, the runner won't fall. Page the follow. And at long last, the Panthers, with so many offensive rebounds, finally get a putback.
And how about the junior Troutman that time? He missed the play, didn't hang his head, came back, made something happen defensively, and got 2 points for his ball club.
Wilkinson. And another steal. This one by Page. No numbers. Quality defense by Wilkinson. Tie ball. The arrow to the Panthers. Defensive transition outstanding for both of these teams. Devin Harris can beat you off the bounce and in a variety of ways.
What can a drawbridge teach us about brokerage firms? When everything comes together, it can be easier to reach your destination. Wachovia Securities welcomes Prudential Securities and its clients. Talk to us. Together, we can achieve uncommon results. Wachovia Securities.
Hitman Jimmy the Tulip is sensitive.
I just vacuumed this rug.
I need your help.
Oz is scared.
You're afraid of everything, Oz.
That is so not true. You are a nitwit, Oz.
Laszlo is mad.
Where's Jimmy?
And Jill is glad.
Why don't we go out and kill somebody tonight?
Wow.
Bruce Willis, Matthew Perry, The Whole 10 Yards, rated PG-13, starts Friday, April 9th.
When you put people first, you make sure help is never far away. Saturn is now available with OnStar. Saturn, people first.
There's glory for the individuals who come together for a common goal. You tame the elusive beast of time and space, bringing together offices from every corner of the globe, working in real time. As if shoulder to shoulder. You have the new Microsoft Office system. Go team.
Wednesday on a special night. Has a budding romance gone to a new level?
Two beautiful women want to make a sandwich out of me.
Would you say no?
Survivor All-Stars on a special night, Wednesday.
Wisconsin with the early lead here in Milwaukee, where all week the talk has been on how this feels like Wisconsin's home court advantage. However, it is literally the home court for three Wisconsin starters. Harris, Owens, and Wade all grew up right here in Milwaukee. Needless to say, tickets have been an issue. In fact, Devin Harris told me that when tickets went on sale at 8 a.m. on Monday morning, he was first in line trying to get his hands on as many as he could, Tim.
Wauwatosa East is high school. McCarroll just into the game, who does bring a face-up big into the lineup for Pittsburgh rather than post-up to make it a 9-8 game. And I don't think there's any doubt that there's high anxiety anytime you're trying to run down tickets and playing in such a meaningful game. Hanson, not there. Pulled down by McCarroll.
And I'm sure the coaching staff tried to manage that as much as possible and not make that a distraction, Tim.
Browser taking it right to the rack and challenging Freddie Owens. Second foul on Freddie, one of the natives of Milwaukee that Heather was mentioning from Washington High School.
One of the keys Bo Ryan talked about was trying to limit Krauser's penetration as much as possible. He's such a catalyst for this ball club. So far, he's been able to crack that veneer on the outside.
Monday on CBS, the key evidence from a crime scene is stolen. Now CSI Miami must find it or a killer walks. Don't miss a new episode of Monday right here on CBS. Offensive rebound. That's McCarroll just into the game, making a big play on the offensive boards again. There have been five offensive rebounds. Make it six now with that one by Pittsburgh. So they're getting a lot of opportunity.
Well, that's where you take a stat and you turn it around. Here you see the good board work off the free throw. But Pitt only four of 15 in this game, but they're getting second chance opportunities. So that shooting percentage, not quite as bad.
McCarroll unable to collect the free throw. Six second chance points for Pittsburgh, none for Wisconsin. So that's certainly been a very meaningful stat early on for the Panthers, who struggled with their shooting.
It only took 10 minutes, Tim, for somebody to get to double figures in this game. Incredible.
Jerron Brown gets the foul, and a sarcastic round of applause from the partisan crowd. How about that Vanderbilt win over North Carolina State? And an intentional foul call that was somewhat controversial, a catalyst, and Julius Hodge fouling out of that game.
A five-point play at the end, really turning the tide for the Commodores.
And a pair of SEC teams now made it into the Sweet 16. And there you see the sarcastic reaction based on team fouls. The Badgers are five more.
Now that's what Bowler and I talked about, matching the physical play. If Pittsburgh sets the tone, they can get the whistle.
McCarroll using the bank, and it is open on Sunday here in Milwaukee.
Nice play. He got his early rhythm on that offensive rebound. 53% shooter, and you see why. I like the guy who uses the glass.
Boulay trying to post up Krauser. That is a tough take. Pittsburgh's guards so much more physical in their upper body, and that helps from a defensive standpoint. And Timmy Higgins spots the foul. Goes against Mader. That's his second.
Mader frustrated. He's going to come out of the ball game. See the action down here low, using the elbow, getting it up high. Got it into Troutman's throat on that play.
Pittsburgh with a Baker's dozen on a 9-0 run in the last 2.5 minutes. Think of how thick they are. Graves is going to be the game. Antonio Graves, who loves to penetrate and create three-point opportunities. This time he decides to take it himself. It would have been wiser to get it back out.
Yeah, it's a tough shot. Somebody new into the ball game. I think you want to get into a little bit more of a sweat before you try to take it one-on-one.
Here's a player that can go one-on-one. Harris. Off the ball. Graves with a little too much body on Clayton Hansen.
How big was Hansen the other night coming in? Those late threes. He was part of that rally in the second half.
Julius Page checking back into the game. Antonio Graves, the freshman from Mansfield, Ohio. We had a big three late in the game with UConn in the Big East tournament that kept the Panthers in it. But a quick shot here gets him back on the bench. Finally, Wisconsin scoreless since the 12:24 mark, a 4-minute drought. It comes to an end thanks to Boo, and you hear the crowd shout Boo after a big play made by Wade.
And when they struggled against Richmond in the first half, it was Boo Wade who came in and picked them up, and there you see the numbers hit. They're seeing a bigger basket, and it continues to grow.
Krauser just inside the arc. He has five. Pittsburgh by four. Morley working it on McCarroll. Again, the deflection this time by Demetrius. Yuri Demetrius just into the game, the junior. Pittsburgh going a little deeper into their bench early in this game, understanding that they may need to, at the very least with fouls to give against Wisconsin. Wilkinson is bumped on his way to the glass. Foul goes against Chris Taft. His second. 7:29 remaining. Bo Knows in Wisconsin. A lot of pressure. Turn up the heat. Badgers and Panthers.
The Bud Light Institute would like to proudly introduce the Toflex, specifically designed to make it easy to burn the ridiculously low carbs in one Bud Light. The Toflex can be used anywhere.
Work it. Ooh. Good.
It helps work those difficult toe muscles.
I can actually feel the burn.
Of course you do.
Breathe.
So get your toes into shape the Bud Light Institute way. Fresh, smooth, real. Bud Light, it's all here.
Hayes outside. Elvin Hayes gets on a beautiful jumper. The Big E. Hayes goes to the baseline. A defensive standout. Hayes is a fine two-way player. Elvin Hayes knows why he's an All-American. Now you like
me, now I say. Think he's good enough to make the Pontiac all-time tournament team? You decide at NCAAsports.com/Pontiac.
You're IT guys, right?
Yeah.
Okay, you gotta help me. My computer has a virus. I've gotta email a presentation or I'm dead. It's for a board meeting. Maybe you just rip out the hard drive.
Oh, no.
Just press the blue button and follow along.
That's it?
That's it.
That's it?
That's it. That is.
That's it.
You ever tried decaf?
Stress-free wireless, only on a ThinkPad with Intel Centrino mobile technology.
1,300 flights a day, huh?
Yeah, to over 200 countries.
Really?
So I can get this to Hong Kong, no problem.
一日飛去200幾個國家?
每日超過1,300班機啊。真的? 所以我要送這個去芝加哥。
Well, next thing you know, you're going to tell me that there's a guy over there just like you.
Seriously, there is.
Uh-huh. Bye-bye.
Global shipping.
See you tomorrow.
With a very familiar face. UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Monday.
I hope it's the biggest hit of all time.
Dates all new with the one and only Tom Hanks.
We're doing the best we can, people.
And music from NERD. Dates all new Monday.
15-11, Pittsburgh with the lead. A couple of guys, Mike, have come off the bench to provide a spark. McCarroll for Pittsburgh has come in, hitting 3 out of 3 in just 6 minutes. And Marley for Wisconsin has helped on the boards. 4 rebounds in 7 minutes for him.
Both of them, their athleticism paying dividends. Marley on the boards, and that's what McCarroll does. He's long, athletic, runs the floor extremely hard.
Harris. Off the front iron, Trotman brings it down. 3 rebounds for Siobhan. Trotman for 3. Rebound to Harris. He'll keep shooting. And he's one of those guys I think is better off the dribble in transition with his 3-point shots.
That's when they'll take him off the leash a little bit, Tim. And they're more structured in the half court, but every once in a while he'll break that, especially on a rush up the floor. He's been much more aggressive looking for a shot in this first half.
Page with a wonderful pass inside to Trotman, but double teamed. He can't get it to fall. Harris tries to run it down, gets the timeout. A hustle play by Devin Harris. 6:34 left. Pittsburgh by 1. Somebody may get to 20 by halftime, we promise.
Hey, LeBron.
Oh, what up, Thirst?
Brother, how about a tour of your new crib?
Oh, come on in. This is my bedroom?
Right. King-size waterbed.
Game room.
Plasma screen, blah, blah, blah.
And this is the kitchen.
Whoa! Oh, no, you didn't. Crisp, clean, ice cold, lemon, lime, Sprite, always at your fingertips.
Check it out. You crying?
It's just so beautiful. Show them my motto. Can a brother get a minute?
When you retire, will you be sitting here or here? Mutual funds from the Hartford, for people who are always thinking ahead. Ask your advisor.
It's Rice. Rice gets a 3. 26 points. It's Rice. Rice with the 3. Look at the smoke coming from his right hand. Rice. Magnificent scoring machine.
Now you like me now, I say.
Think he's good enough to make the Pontiac all-time tournament team? You decide at NCAAsports.com/Pontiac.
Ugh. Stop using messy athlete's foot cream. Try Gold Bond Foot Swabs, the maximum strength medicine you can trust. Snap to release the only medicine proven to cure and prevent most athlete's foot.
With no mess.
Gold Bond Foot Swabs, the no mess, no touch cure.
Why do we rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car makes all the difference.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Who says the president dropped the ball on terrorism to go to war in Iraq? One of his own former White House advisors. Tonight on 60 Minutes.
It has been dominated with defense, as advertised. Pittsburgh only shooting 30%. They've gotten some turnovers. Wisconsin 33%. 5 out of 15 shooting. Both the guards really trying to will their way. You think of Devin Harris and Carl Krauser, the anchors of both of these teams.
And in different ways. Devin Harris doing it through the jump shot from the outside, establishing the perimeter. Carl Krauser, the ground attack, getting inside and penetrating. He's got 7 rebounds in this game already, Tim.
They switch out, put Page on Harris, and he uses the window. 8 in the game for Devin.
Just a very explosive player. You can't afford to let him get to his right hand.
Krauser ooping, trying to get McCarroll. He thought there was enough contact for a whistle, but to no avail.
Ron Brown now drawing the assignment against Harris. 8 points early is a good sign for Devin, but they're all hard earned. Harris not there.
An interesting shot by Harris. A long three. Still had plenty of time on the clock to make something happen off the dribble.
This young man Hansen is really appreciated by this fan base. You can tell that hustle play. He was rewarded with a nice ovation. Page working in on Ray Nixon. Uses the glass. He may be waking up after a 4-game slump. He's 2 out of 6 now, and the Panthers lead by 1.
Right, and he was really stubborn in taking the jump shot the other night, and I think he's done a much better job in trying to get inside, get some easier opportunities to get his confidence back.
Nixon finds Harris on the low block. Quickly doubled. McCarroll ran away from him, and then he took advantage and got the foul from Jerron Brown. McCarroll just snuck away a bit too quickly, and Harris took advantage.
Well, this is the player of the year in the regular season and also the MVP of the Big Ten tournament, Devin Harris, a very explosive offensive player. But asking him, Tim, he actually feels that playmaking comes more naturally to him, and he's had to really work at being a primetime scorer. Usually it's the opposite.
Yeah. There's his father, Terry, looking on. One of the many to get some of those tickets offline by Devin. You know, he did admit to us yesterday when we chatted that he had some butterflies before that game back on Friday night. He said, but I did notice during that run, even some Marquette fans were rooting for us.
That's a stretch in this city.
Yeah, inside state pride sometimes will occur. Private school versus public. McCarroll not there. Trotman again gets a finger on it. Hanson on the deck. He's Mr. Floorburn for this Badger team.
Well, he spent more time prone in this game than anywhere else, but that's his role and he understands it.
Wilkinson. Foul will go against Siobhan Trotman. His first.
There's an early aggressiveness to the offensive looks that Wisconsin's trying to get, banging the ball inside on the post. See Wilkinson's night's work against Richmond, 18 points, a lot of those in the second half, and he hit the key jump shot in the middle that really sparked that run. 14 of those points in the second half.
Speaking of power forwards, make sure you vote for your starting forwards on the Pontiac All-Time Tournament team. You can cast your ballot now at ncaasports.com/Pontiac. He is a power forward to be sure. What a great influence. Devin Harris, a little blow on the bench. Wisconsin nursing a 3-point lead. A 9-2 run for the Badgers. Page trying to run Hanson through the curl.
Round out of a sneaker on the play. 4-on-5.
Krauser. And the runner won't fall. Trotman just there to lunch pail his way to a deuce.
He's a warrior, Tim. He's a guy you've got to really concentrate on and almost face guard him and check him off the glass.
6 lead changes and 4 ties in this game. Pittsburgh looking for a lead change right here off the steal. Krauser goes crossover. Tough shot. The tap out to Page. Gets it back into Carl's hands. He's just perpetual motion.
But the first shot was not a good attempt, and he felt like he was going to get a call on that play. That one was much more under control. You can live with that jump shot.
That is the 7th lead change of the afternoon. Wilkinson, whose game off the dribble has really improved since a year ago. Another rebound for Trautman. He has six of them. Krauser, wave it off, fouled with the ball on the floor. With 3:04 remaining. Goes against Boo Wade, his second.
This is the one thing Jamie Dixon likes about Krauser, his ability to hit free throws. He hits some big late shots against Central Florida. 9 of 10 on that game. That's a great quality to have in your point guard who is solid at the free throw line.
His counterpart, Devin Harris, back into the game. 10 points, 3 boards, 2 assists, and 2 threes for Devin. Monday's all new on CBS, beginning with Yes, Dear, and Still Standing. Then it's Everybody Loves Raymond and 2 and a Half Men, followed by Monday's number one drama, CSI Miami. Plus The Late Show with David Letterman, all Monday right here on America's Most Watched Network.
I've got that one memorized. Yes, Dear. Yes, Dear.
Well, we all need direction, don't we? If not, yes, your wife dear. At home. Brando on the road. Carl Krauser waking it up.
What's inside?
Oh, yeah.
Nokia, connecting people.
Ten of crisp, extra mayo.
Hey. Usual, no tomato. Great, huh? Thank you. Ten of crisp, double lettuce, double mayo, no tomato.
Yes, sir.
We got the same thing. There we go. We get the same thing.
A couple more buns in here, Ethan. Huh? Want to kiss them?
Mouth-stretching chicken breast wrapped in crisp deliciousness. The new Tender Crisp.
Have it your way.
Where would we be if we always did things the way they were done before?
3, 2, 1.
Where would we be if everyone followed?
3, 2, 1.
And no one led.
And I'm never ever gonna get it up. I'm never ever gonna get it up.
Our game summary, as you look at the bottom of that graphic, the fact that Harrison Krauser, Mike, have become more productive has made the game, in your opinion, a bit better from an offensive standpoint.
Yeah, I think it took a little while for each team to feel out the other's defense, and these are two of the best in the country. But lately, it seems like points have been a little bit easier to come by, and your team, you're looking at the inching up into the 33% field goal range.
Sounds like little, but for these two, has been a lot. Pittsburgh, a quick 6-0 spurt in the last minute 15. Grab this 3-point lead. Both teams so efficient defensively, almost 4 straight points.
Huge run.
We're talking spurt.
That's right.
Wilkinson. Nice read into Dixon. Siobhan Trautman got a hand on it. There's Marley again, and he's fouled. So very active. Jerron Brown gets the foul, his second against Zach Morley.
And that is a difficult place to lose your dribble. Wisconsin very lucky to get an offensive rebound in that situation. Morley has been very active on the glass since coming into this game.
Third leading scorer on the team. Well, speaking of spurt ability, coming up on Singular at the half, Greg, Special K, and Seth Davis will get you updated on all the tournament news, scores, and highlights. Plus, a live look at all the action going on in the NCAA tournament that's coming up on Singular at the half. I'll be curious to see what Clark's review of Lynn Elmore's call was, and that was a very bad intentional foul call
against North Carolina State. In that Vandy comeback, it turned out to be a 5-point play when Mario Moore made a huge three.
It did look like the dribbler just went into Marcus Melvin on that play as opposed to any sort of attempt to not play the ball.
Certainly did aid Kevin Stallings' team, but a backdoor cut is what did in North Carolina State in the end.
5-point play when you got a 6-point deficit is a huge move.
Harley another rebound. He has six. Vanderbilt would have to be considered a surprise entry into the Sweet 16, as would Alabama. Hanson can't connect, and Taft, the outstanding freshman, gets a rebound, his first. Most of the guards have been collecting the rebounds for Pittsburgh today.
And Jaron Brown made that play, stood up the cutter, Devin Harris, and it really broke down the whole rhythm of that offensive set.
High pick and roll for Krauser, set up by Taft. He's got so many gears. Harris tried to flop to no avail. Shot clock at 10. Turn the page. Julius's game is on. He's now hit three field goals, largest lead of the game for either team.
Set himself up inside. All of a sudden now that jump shot is a lot easier stroke.
This is a very tough Pittsburgh team. You really have to be impressed with the way they've taken the crowd out of this game. Marley for three. Troutman with another rebound. Seven for him this afternoon.
Tim, not unlike Boston College in that they'll just grind it out and grind it out and really take you out of your rhythm.
They'd like to see more of that from Julius Page.
Great teams are often forged over the hot coals of adversity. Eve of the big meeting, the third quarter numbers suddenly changed. But so did your presentation, automatically. You have the new Microsoft Office system. It's a Cinderella story.
You look at Jamie Dixon, and all he's done this year is win 30 games in his first season as a head coach, culminating what has been a three-year span for a team that has the best record in Division 1A.
And that really has positioned himself well in the first 20 minutes here. Didn't talk about it? Playing on the road. Basically, he's taken this crowd out of it, a very disciplined scheme for Pitt, although they get a turnover.
Devin Harris with the pilfer.
360, yes! Their last field goal came at 619, so that ends a drought.
Jamie Dixon irritated at that play. You don't want to call a timeout, set a play, and then come out and turn it over for a basket.
Krauser.
Pitt is not finishing this half well.
It's not at all what Jamie Dixon wanted out of that timeout. And they have a chance to tie or pull to within one, and they go to the 1-4 set. Tab comes out to show. There it is. We're tied.
Tim, Pitt gave up a 5-point lead in the last 50 seconds by a bad turnover and a bad shot.
Coming up at halftime, Greg Gumbel and company at Studio 43 in New York, as advertised, Wisconsin and Pittsburgh.
About to become two.
Hey, what are you doing?
He lost a piece of evidence. We have to find it.
And the clues to a woman's murder will come from an unexpected source.
Ants, people eat them?
It's supposed to be an aphrodisiac.
A new CSI Miami, CBS Monday.
A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
This is March Madness on wheels at your Pontiac dealer. The time of year when you step it up and leave the weak stuff at home. Here comes the ready or not.
qualified lessees leave your checkbook at home and lease a Grand Am SE for around $182 a month with nothing due at signing. Tax, title, license, and dealer fees extra. Call for details.
March Madness on Wheels at your Pontiac dealer.
I have two daughters, a dog, and my furniture.
I have three sons, a cat, and my furniture. We just got married, so it was either move out or up.
Terry at National City suggested a home equity line of credit to help us build a second story.
Now we just have to decide whose furniture stays and whose furniture goes.
At National City, we want to make banking simple for lives that aren't.
Special, so special. We're the Warners.
And our bank is National City.
Right now, visit your Chevy dealer and leave your checkbook at home. Introducing zero down, zero due at signing, zero security deposit. That's right. Qualified lessees can lease an Impala sedan for around $219 a month with zero due at signing. Tax, title, license, and dealer fees extra. Residency restrictions apply. Call for important lease details. Hurry, offer ends March 31st. Chevy, turn the key. Start a revolution. Chevy, the best-selling cars and trucks in Pittsburgh for the last 6 years.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular Wireless, the wireless company that fits you best.
Hi, everyone. Welcome once again to our studios here in New York and to Singular at the Half. I'm Greg Gumbel along with Clark Kellogg and Seth Davis. At halftime, it's a 26-26 tie, Pittsburgh and Wisconsin. Meanwhile, in Kansas City, Pacific and Kansas, 36-32. Jayhawks are leading. Coming up on a minute to play in the first half, we go live to Craig Bowlerjack and Bob Wenzel.
In Kansas City, Kansas and Pacific heading down the stretch run to final minute. Yango rips down another rebound for Pacific. A four-point Jayhawk lead.
Pacific's passing has been crisp. Teamwork has been great. 9 assists on 11 baskets so far for the Tigers.
Langford leads Kansas with 9. Dudley and Yango both with 9 for Pacific. 14 on the shot. Newton lost it. Langford calls a timeout.
Heads up play by Langford.
26 and change remaining in the opening half at Kemper.
My old Nationwide wireless plan said they didn't charge me for roaming.
Yeah, right.
If I stayed in network, but if you can't even see the network, yoo-hoo. Network, I'm in the network. Oh, network. How do you stay in it?
There's no in or out of network with the new Singular Nation. You never pay roaming or long distance, even with your nationwide mobile-to-mobile minutes.
I call it my plan.
The new Singular Nation, another reason Singular fits you best.
Sold out Kemper Arena in Kansas City. And that front court scoring, a major factor for KU.
Well, Graves and Simeon inside are extremely powerful, wide bodies, and they are doing it inside so far. That is where Kansas wants to go.
They have combined for 15 of the 36 Jayhawk points. 26 seconds remain.
2-2-1. Designed to slow it down, take some time off the clock, and then get back into the 3-2 zone, which has been very effective and gotten Pacific back in this game. They were down early. 5 or 6 times, Kansas came up empty against this zone.
6 seconds left. Miles puts it on the floor, now switches to the left hand. Cockle, good defense. The buzzer, rounded out by Langford. Halftime, Kansas by 4 over Pacific. From Kansas City to New York, here's Greg.
All right, Craig, thanks very much. So there's our halftime score, the Jayhawks by 4. If you're the Pacific coach, what are you going to tell your players at halftime?
Basically, keep playing the zone defense and attack the rim at the other end.
All right, in Columbus, Ohio, the Blazers and the Kentucky Wildcats. This is a number 9 seed and a number 1 seed. 42-31, the Blazers in the lead, 2:37 to play. We join Dick Enberg and Matt Kukas.
The winner heads to St. Louis in the Sweet 16, and the underdog UAB Blazers have a 42-31 lead over the number 1 seed, Kentucky Wildcats. 3-point shooting by the Blazers. They've been on.
UAB doing it from beyond the arc, 6 for 10.
from out there. Gabe Kennedy doing a nice job inside out. And it has been Bo Finley, 2 out of 3. Squeaky Johnson, 3 out of 4. And there have been hands in their face on some of these. But normally, Kentucky only gives up 32% three-point shooting.
Well, let's talk about Kentucky's defense. They have not allowed a team all season long in 31 games to shoot 50%. And the Blazers hitting 57% in this first half. There you see it. Season just 40, one of the best in the country. Now we saw the same in the earlier game. Cincinnati boasts of a great defense, and Illinois tore them apart. Johnson with 9, Finley with 8, Art Taylor with 7 for the Blazers, and Barry Daniels leads Kentucky with 10. Hawkins, and the rolls to Fitch.
Daniels getting an extended stay on the bench with those two personal fouls.
Down to 5 on the shot clock. Fitch has to hurry and forces the 3. And the rebound to Tony Johnson. And the men in green hurry it into the offensive end. This is Squeaky Johnson. He's had a hot hand. Ronnell Taylor over on Zabuke. Hayes battles with Ettens. And look at the play. He knocks it off. Antoine Barber out of bounds to UAB. He had that sensational 26-point game against Washington.
Kentucky is very small right now. Watch this save right off the button of Antoine Barber. And also with Daniels on the bench, Kentucky at the offensive end and can't get that little high-low action, which is so effective for them.
Ricky Johnson almost lost it to Fitch. Evans takes it in. And the rebound to Hayes, and he's surrounded by Green. Somebody should be open, but look how quickly the Blazers get back on defense. Fitch forced to alter his shot, has trouble controlling the ball. It's a turnover to UAB. It just seems like there's 7.5 men out there, and that's what Mike Anderson coaches, that kind of defense.
Gerald Fitch getting his own miss and stumbling, but shuffling the feet. Accurate call by the officials. And Dick, the reason that UAB can get back in transition like that is Cliff Hawkins is pounding the ball too much. Instead of looking up and passing the ball ahead, I don't care how fast you are, you can't catch up with the ball.
7th turnover committed by Kentucky as we tick down toward 1 minute left in the half. Tony Johnson, good inside pass to Kennedy. Batted out to Evans. 3 for Ronnell Taylor. No, and Hayes rebound. Again, it's Hawkins with a dribble, and he travels. Something slippery in that area. That's 2 in a row, maybe from the last fall of his teammate Fitch. Hawkins slipping in that perspiration.
And the defense of Squeaky Johnson having a little bit to do with it, but once again, Cliff Hawkins is bound and determined to tattoo that ball into the floor. And again, when you're in the middle of the break as a point guard, you've got to dribble some, but you've also got to look ahead and throw back.
Into the final minute. Look at the brackets. And that's going to be a foul as Squeaky Johnson took it inside against the much taller Kentucky Trees. Winner of this game will meet either Pacific or Kansas in the Sweet 16 round. Now they're going to call that just out of bounds. And
big break for Chuck Hayes. That would have been his second to join Eric Daniels with 2.
Hawkins on Squeaky Johnson. 37 seconds. 10 on the shot clock, and Squeaky Johnson lost the ball, and now out of bounds, Gabe Kennedy off his knee. So Kentucky with the shot clock off, 31 seconds left in this first half.
Good defensive play by Cliff Hawkins, but they came away grabbing his back again. I don't know if it's fatigue or the back is bothering him, or both.
And Kentucky will use a timeout with 22 seconds left in the half. Tubby Smith wants that final hoop of the half.
I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Mattawa, La Paloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Salvador, Amarillo, Tocopilla, Barranquilla, and Padilla. I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere.
After 2 separate stays at any Comfort Inn, Comfort Suites, Quality, Sleep-In, Clarion, or Mainstay Suites, you'll earn a free night with choice privileges. The more you stay, the more you earn. For reservations or more details, visit choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
We're back in Columbus, Ohio, and a reminder tonight on CBS. Who says the president dropped the ball on terrorism to go to war in Iraq? Well, one of his own former White House advisors. You'll see it tonight on 60 Minutes. A big lineup tonight, including a terrific movie at 9 o'clock. So stay with us after basketball. The drama continues here in the final seconds of the first half as Tubby Smith's heavily favored Kentucky Wildcats down by 11. No points in the last 3.5 minutes for Kentucky, and they have 22 seconds to try to do something about that.
And this is when they usually look for Gerald Fitch. He's been quiet, relatively speaking, 2 for 7 from the field this first half.
Down to 14 seconds. Down to 11, and a foul is called. Mike Anderson didn't like that a bit. The second on Squeaky Johnson.
So they're about 11 seconds short of halftime, and Alabama-Birmingham, 42-31 leader. Surprised?
No, not really, because UAB is wearing down Kentucky with that constant pressure, and they're making the three-point shot. That's a lethal combination if you're Kentucky.
It's Kentucky's worst nightmare. They only play 6 guys.
All right, guys, time now for the singular one-on-one with Billy Packer Trivia Challenge. Which school has the longest streak of consecutive NCAA tournament appearances?
Wait North for you to tell us.
We need some answers.
North Carolina.
North Carolina, of course. There it is.
27 consecutive
B, I say
years,
B.
From 75 through 2001 for a chance to win a trip to the Final Four. Send a text message to 26222 or log on to CBSSportsLine.com/2NCAA. One coaching note. CBS Sports has learned that Tom Penders is expected to take over the coaching reins at the University of Houston. Right now, Penders is headed to Houston to finalize details of his contract. His coaching resume includes Texas, George Washington, and Rhode Island. Thanks for joining us here on Singular at the Half. Back to Milwaukee for the second half right after this.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular Wireless, the wireless company that fits you best.
Quick, in the top 5 water polo players in the world. Okay. How about one? Yeah. I didn't start playing water polo to get famous. And the same goes for being a biology major. I like working in protein chemistry. Quick, name the top 5 protein chemists in the world.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Coca-Cola presents the month-long Crazy Ride.
This is what you dream about when you play basketball from the time you're a little kid.
Play ball here and play and win.
Let's go! Let's go! We play the best team in the nation and the worst team in the nation. We play the same way. We didn't come here to come close, and we came here to win the game.
Terry Hatcher has her eye on Charlie's brother.
I forbid you to have anything to do with my sister.
What are you going
to
do, Judith? Divorce me? Marry me again and then divorce me?
On your 2.5 Men, CBS Monday.
At halftime in Milwaukee, Wisconsin and Pittsburgh are tied at 26. More on this outstanding second round matchup coming up.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with my new Kia Sedona. It's got a 10-year warranty. Jersey gonna have that?
No.
It was $2,300 less, and I got 3 years free maintenance.
You got free maintenance?
Yeah.
Dare to compare a Kia Sedona before you buy. With a 5-star safety rating, a 10-year warranty, and now for a limited time, get 3 years free maintenance. When you add it all up, there's no comparison.
I almost lost the entire backyard to crabgrass, and I vowed that would never happen again. The following year, I did use Turf Builder Plus Halts. It not only got rid of the crabgrass, but it also greened up the lawn and thickened it. I used the cheaper brands, but I didn't have the color that I wanted, and I did have the weeds. Look how thick it is. Look at the color of it. There are no weeds. I take the credit instead of Scott's. I call it Luby Lawn. I'm very proud of the results that I get from Scott's, and there will be no crabgrass.
You've got to step up. Close out all of the pressure. Trust everything you've been taught. And just believe you can do it. You know, my first day on the job sure felt familiar.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Wednesday.
She was alive, and she was entombed.
Don't miss the final 90 seconds of CSI on a special night.
Get your kit.
Wednesday at 10, 9 Central.
An entertaining second half coming up after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship.
Why do we rent from Enterprise? Because having the right car makes all the difference.
Grandma, look, they're here.
Hi, Grandma.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Introducing the Malibu Max. The only car that offers all of this. Remote start, sliding reclining rear seats, a 200 horsepower V6, and rear DVD. The new Chevrolet's an American revolution.
What happens when the All-Stars don't know we're watching them? Survivor All-Stars on a special night, CBS Wednesday.
Spring, Comcast Digital Cable will have you seeing stars. Not those. These stars. Order Comcast Digital Cable this month and get stars free for 6 months. Stars delivers award-winning movies. Stars kids has favorites like Finding Nemo. And with Stars On Demand, you can order up to 100 different movies a month free. Try doing that with a dish. Order Comcast Digital Cable this month and get stores free for 6 months. Plus, call today and get connected by tomorrow. Call now.
This offseason, I've been more sensitive, understanding. Well, that time's over. Ted, get the hat.
Get ready to run, maggots! But first, lights out! Get the Dick's Sporting Goods for Nike Shox Turbos. Get Under Armour plus Nike Air Conversions for game day. Let's review. Dick's Sporting Goods, Nike, Under Armour. Dick's and Cleats, just take your pick.
Every season starts at Dick's.
Spring is kicking into high gear at your neighborhood Ford store. And the big spring breakout is busting loose. Right now, bonus cash means $42.50 cash back on the 2004 Explorer 4-door. Or take $12.50 cash back with 0% APR for 5 years and watch your savings multiply. Yeah, spring is here. And we're celebrating with great deals on the best-selling cars and trucks in America for 17 years straight. See your neighborhood Ford store today.
Sports exclusive coverage of the Men's Basketball Championship is sponsored by IBM. Choice Hotels, eBay, and by the new Chevrolets.
A tough, grounded-out game between the Big Ten and the beasts of the Big East, Pittsburgh and Wisconsin. Tim Randall, Mike Jaminski. The last 50 seconds of that half, though, really didn't help Pittsburgh at all.
No, Tim, great teams finish halves and finish games. Pitt did not handle that last 50 seconds well at all. And a 5-point lead in this game is huge, and they gave that up very quickly. Take a look at the halftime stats. Both teams, we thought it'd be tough sledding offensively, and they're both shooting around 35%. 3-point shooting, that's been a big advantage for Wisconsin, 4-10 in this game. Points in the paint, big for Pitt. They've got 8 offensive rebounds, 8 second chance points. The leading scorer, Devin Herron, of course, he has been much more aggressive. Carl Krauser has also been aggressive getting into the lane.
Look at the difference from round one to today. Now, granted, you know that Jamie Dixon has enough confidence in his defense that he's not going to run two people at Devin Harris, as Jerry Wainwright did of Richmond. But to some extent, the Pitt defense, as good as it is, has not been able to handle this Milwaukee native.
Well, they don't have to run at him now. I suspect as the game goes along that he's going to draw some more attention, and they may make other people beat them. But up to this point, mostly Jerron Brown has been given the task of trying to guard Devin Harris off the dribble.
One of the things that has happened in this game, Wilkinson has not been as much of an offensive force, Mike, but Taft has not been that outstanding on the boards for Pittsburgh either. So it's been a bit of a wash between the bigs of both teams.
At 26 points, Tim, it's tough to find an offensive force. Devin Harris won, and that's about it.
Yeah. Wilkinson almost lost his dribble. Saved by Boué. Not there. Siobhan Trotman with the rebound for Pittsburgh. Just underway, second half. Two outstanding teams, a 3 seed and a 6. And Chris Taft, the freshman of influence, with his first bucket of the game. The young man from Coney Island, New York. 5-point leads have been the largest of the day for either team.
Ted, that could be a big boost to their offense if the freshman can get going. They tried to get him in rhythm early in this game. He didn't respond, but knocks one down there. Maybe that's a confidence builder.
Harris off the bounce. Got caught in midair. A mistake, and Carl Krauser picked it out of there.
Good transition defense on the turnover by Wisconsin.
Page with the ball fake, and off the jump stop gives it up to Siobhan Trotman. At different times in this game, the guards have taken over, both Krauser and Devin Harris. The last 50 seconds of the first half was all Krauser to tie the game. Julius Page on the wing, who has hit 3 field goals. He's been mired in a very difficult slump the last couple of weeks.
Tried to run a little flare screen for him. Had a good look at it.
Harris trying the post up now against Jerron Brown.
Brown too strong for him down low, Tim.
Wilkinson, usually the next best option, and he misses the finger roll.
Harris is usually a pretty good post player, and they will give their guards opportunities, but I think Jerron Brown a little too wide for him.
You could say that about most of the Pittsburgh guards. Brown certainly, Trotman, Krauser is an outstanding, when you think about it, his size and his upper body belies the stature. He plays much larger than his height with his upper body once he gets inside. And there's an example of it. Takes it inside and collects the foul.
That's just the New York City and Krauser coming out. And normally you have a big in front of you. You're not going to try to take him off the dribble. But with Mader standing there, he felt like he'd at least get around him and get to the free throw line.
Dave Mader picks up his third. Zach Morley, we saw plenty of him in the first half. Morley made a difference when coming off the bench, as did Mark McCarroll for Pittsburgh. And it is Morley coming into the game for Mader.
Just the athleticism that Morley brings is what Bo Ryan was looking for in that first half.
Two outstanding programs. You could legitimately say that these two teams could have matched up a week from now with a trip to San Antonio on the line rather than a trip to East Rutherford. Oklahoma State awaits the winner of this matchup next week.
Both coaches were talking about the fact, oh, we have to win this one just to get to the Sweet 16.
Boué, nice cut, and Morley found him.
Taking advantage, the defender lost sight of where Boué was. Automatic back cut to the rim when that happens.
And this partisan crowd trying to pick up the Badgers. Ron Brown in traffic. There's that size and strength. You talk about playing position basketball. He can do it. That's his first bucket of the afternoon.
And Pitt needs to get him going.
Page the rebound as Harris can't connect. Krauser creates the open three for Page.
And all of a sudden, two very good possessions, and Jerron Brown had a hand in both of them. He is very much a playmaker in the half court for Pitt.
And the largest lead of the day for either team, up to 7. Morley, nice move. Boy, what an impact he's had. He loves to go baseline, and he's got those nice moves around the cup.
Well, I thought it was lazy defense by Taft. Never had his hands up. I don't think he was expecting Morley to come back with that little flip hook.
Marley with the 6 points, six rebounds. Ball was deflected out of bounds. It will be controlled to Pitt. That's just what Jamie Dixon wanted to see. Another chapter in the page of Julius's play.
What's this? That's a blade.
Blade?
That's a blade.
Blade's a server.
This is a server?
That's a server.
Where's all the stuff?
Stuff? What stuff?
The plugs, the cables, you know.
In the Blade Center?
Blade Center. Where you put the blades? What's a blade?
You're messing with me, right?
Highly simplified, affordable IBM eServer Blade Center with Intel Xeon processors.
It's the Mighty Mouse of cars. Meet the surprisingly big Chevy Avail.
Hey, 35-30, Pittsburgh with the lead tonight on CBS. Who says the president dropped the ball on terrorism to go to war in Iraq? Well, one of his own former White House advisors tonight on 60 Minutes. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, Heather Cox, happy to have you with us. Pittsburgh with a 5-point lead. Charles are trying to use those high picks from Taft. Now he slides down to the low block, and the freshman can't get it to fall. And Jerron Brown, who finally got into the scoring column, was his first field goal of the tournament. He was 0 for 8 prior to that, and he couldn't get that put back.
I really saw a steady diet of double teams the other night there. UCF really trying to keep it out of his hands.
And Krauser with the reach in picks up the foul. Clayton Hansen at the line. An original walk-on. And usually your perimeter jumper had better fall if you're going to stay with this team and get a scholarship. If you look at our tournament summary, the Big East is now 7-3. They lost Boston College earlier today. The Big Ten with only Illinois and Wisconsin playing. And look at that, Nevada and Pacific, the only two teams remaining west of the Central Time Zone. We're talking Washington, BYU, Utah, Stanford, Arizona, the Zags, all gone. And only five teams are left who are west of the Mississippi. Kansas, Texas, Oklahoma State, Nevada, and Pacific. Brown, offensive foul.
Pretty good defensive play that time by Hansen, moving his feet. Brown, a left-handed player, trying to get to his right. You can see he's trying to manufacture some more scoring opportunities for himself, Tim, but good defense that time wins out.
By the way, that victory today by Vanderbilt pulls at the SEC to 6-3. Kentucky's in some trouble today against UAB. The ACC losing half of its teams today. They're 9-3 on this 2004 tournament. Nice flash to the basket, and again, he has just made such a difference. Zach Morley.
Taft, I think, is a disadvantage defending out front. That's what you want to do. You want to take a shot blocker, make him move laterally.
He's got the crowd on his feet. Around the bucket, he has been devastating.
The new Colorado Z71 with an available 220 horsepower engine.
You're it.
Don't let all that power go to your head. Chevy, an American revolution.
Hey, yo, Thirst, let me get a Sprite.
No doubt. What's better than Sprite when it's hotter than a devil's drawers?
Oh, here he goes.
I'm serious. That thirst-quenching lemon lime hitting the back of your throat, splat-ow. Really? Name one thing that's better. You can't. There is nothing better. I dare you. I double dog dare you. I defy you to name one thing. All right, name two. Show him my motto. Hey, girls, throw it in reverse for Thirst.
People aren't used to getting money, but once they do, they like it.
Gave me money?
Move your mutual funds to E-Trade Securities, the one place that rebates half of 12b1 fees. If you could own the same mutual funds and get cash back every year, why on earth wouldn't you? Call 1-800-ETRADE1 or visit etrade.com.
Taco Bell's new Fiesta Taco Salad. All the tastes you love with a new tangy chunky salsa and new lime seasoned crunchy tortilla strips. Now even more irresistible. For a taco salad that's even better than the original, think outside the bun.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? For more cargo room. More people room. Or more headroom. Enterprise. So easy, it's like having a second car. Or third.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
When does virtual reality go too far?
He experienced sex with Sylvie long distance.
This guy's a rapist.
I don't own my body anymore.
The new Century City, Tuesday.
Pittsburgh by three. Follow the game on CBS Sportsline's Game Center and get more than just the game. Get play-by-play coverage as it happens without having to refresh the page. Check it out at CBSSportsline.com. Pittsburgh by three, and were it not for the play of Zach Morley off the bench, Wisconsin would be in a lot of trouble. Page falling away that time, raising the rim, and here comes Devin Harris. It's been a while since we've heard from him. Who Wade off the back iron again, another rebound for Morley, leading to a three.
By how many times, Tim, do you see it on an offensive rebound, a great opportunity to knock down a three? Four threes now in the game for Devin Harris.
Here comes the crowd. We're tied at 35. 6 minutes gone by. Harris the rebound. He has five of them. Stop and go. Wave it off. Fouled with the ball on the deck. But a foul against Pitt.
Well, that, this could be the difference maker in this game. Wisconsin's ability to knock down the three. The defense, everybody compressed in that offensive rebounding situation. Nobody able to get a hand up on Harris.
Wisconsin is 5 of 12 from downtown. Harris has four of them. He's 4 of 7. And Morley around the basket, just unstoppable, it seems, against a defense that generally has its way in the interior.
But Chris Taft out of the ball game, McCarroll in, not the shot blocking presence nor the size. Morley recognizing that and going at him.
Pitt once had a 7-point lead. Now they're down two. Wilkinson the rebound. Krauser the pilfer. Stays with it. Hansen comes out of there. Now Harris tries stop and go. Leaves it for Hansen. Troutman the rebound. He has 9 boards in the game, does Siobhan. Make it 10.
Very physical play inside by both teams. Referees are letting them play on.
I love it, don't you?
Absolutely. Let the players decide it.
Brown into that double team. Tom O'Neill does spot a foul with 9 on the shot clock.
Here's the look down here. Watch it. This is a guard in Krauser going against Wilkinson. Wilkinson actually threw him down on the ground.
Is that a strong upper body that young man has? McCarroll too strong off the window. Troutman again, his 11th board. Can't get it to fall. And the foul spotted again underneath. This time against Bouway. His third. And Bo Ryan in disbelief. It has now been a 4.5-minute drought for Pittsburgh. Page. Not there. Once again, Siobhan Troutman on the offensive boards. 12 rebounds and now a putback.
That's been an issue all game for Wisconsin, the inability to close out on the defensive glass. Even though the poor shooting, they're getting second chances.
Harris. Five out of eight from downtown Milwaukee for the Milwaukee native.
21 points.
Boy, and when he's in rhythm and he can swing to that right hand, it's automatic.
Eight lead changes in the game. Wade the rebound. Remember, Wisconsin, with this largely partisan crowd in their favor, can have big-time spurts. They had 19 straight possessions with a bucket against Richmond in the second half. And that foul is on a reach. It'll go against Julius Page, his second.
Morley had two smalls on him, so his instinct was to go to the rim.
Oh, the advantage of playing near your home in round two, and the advantage of having someone like Devin Harris.
Of Putnam Investments strives for consistent, dependable, superior performance over the long term. For good reason, you. At Putnam Investments, we urge you to consider the investment objective, risks, charges, and fees for any fund. Ask your financial advisor or plan sponsor for a prospectus containing this and other information. Read it carefully before you invest. There's no assurance any fund will be able to meet its objective.
A beautiful thing about women, they don't sweat like a guy.
Arm & Hammer Ultramax Antiperspirant Gel.
It's made just for guys.
Superior odor protection versus the leading gel at 8, 12, even 24 hours.
That's all the muscle a man needs.
Ultramax Gel.
The X Factor. You know it's a part of the game. Is it a part of you? Introducing new Gatorade X-Factor. Two great flavors fused together under one cap.
No inhibitions, make no conditions. Get a little out of line. The best thing about being a woman is a prerogative to have a little.
The new Chevy Colorado Crew Cab has the biggest interior in its class. Everything's bigger in Colorado.
Man, I feel like a woman.
The new Chevrolets, an American revolution.
Your husband isn't dead. He's alive.
I just can't keep hoping.
Is that wrong then?
Absolutely.
Proof of Life, network premiere CBS Tonight.
Our game summary, Wisconsin on a 12-2 run, and Mike Jaminski, this is the seventh time that Harris has hit at least five threes. What can Pittsburgh do? They've got a suffocating defense to change things.
Well, and it may be a situation now, Tim, you're starting to get in a point of the game where you want to try to take the ball out of his hands and make other people beat you a little bit in reverse of what Richmond did the other day, where they really kind of stifled him early, but he was able to get into it late.
Wilkinson. Big Mike double-teamed and a whistle prior to the shot. It will go against Antonio Graves, who just came into the game during the timeout. That's number two on him. Harris running baseline. Ball was deflected. Hanson can't corral it. And it winds up in the G-man's hands. Good hands, big fella.
Ready to shoot. Where's the rim?
Just like a Spinarkle feed back in the day. 9 minutes gone by. Wisconsin by three. Ooping, Krauser to Taft. Actually, Jerron Brown. Beautiful pass.
You have to have more pressure out on the passer. Jerron Brown very good at making that play, and a good catch by Taft.
Freddie Owens now working on Krauser. Jerron Brown trying to deal with Devin Harris. Tough shot. Antonio Graves, the rebound for Pittsburgh. Brown finds Taft. Boy, that's a marvelous pass, an even better catch, almost Velcro on that left paw of the freshman, Chris Tabb.
Tim, I told you earlier in the half court, Jerron Brown is as much a playmaker as Krauser is, and he has had two assists in the last two possessions.
Krauser running at Freddie Owens picks up the foul.
Here's the look. You see the seal, and that's the most important thing. If you're a big and you've got somebody front of you, make sure you keep enough space so that you can go up and make the catch. And the one thing about Taft, he's got marvelous hands, and that is really a huge benefit to a center on the run.
Yeah, when you look at that in slow motion, it you know, that was a dart that was thrown, and to pick it out of the air with one hand and put it up nicely off the window, not as easy as Taft made it look. Morley with a dump down, playing a two-man game with Nixon. Lost it that time, trying to drive to the basket.
Wisconsin has been a little casual at the basketball in the last minute and a half. Ninth turnover of the game. That's about where they their average on the year, just under that.
Krauser recovers that one nicely for Pittsburgh. Well, you talked about Jerron Brown, and he has really been very patient with his game. Had been 0-of-8 for the tournament. And after he made a couple of buckets, he started making contributions in a variety of ways. McCarroll. Here's Jerron Brown right on cue with an offensive rebound, and that's what's kept Pitt in it.
And this is what Pitt loves to do. They'll grind you out for a possession, get the offensive rebound, and do it again. It turns it into almost a one-minute affair.
Look at that, 11 offensive rebounds for the Panthers. You just can't get too far away from either team, can you? Oh, I love this.
Funds from the Hartford for people who are always thinking ahead. Ask your advisor.
Tonight begins with America's number one news magazine, 60 Minutes, followed by television's most watched new drama, Cold Case. Then Russell Crowe, Meg Ryan, and David Caruso star in the network premiere of Proof of Life. It's all here tonight on CBS, America's most watched network. In a game of 6-point runs, and there's Devin Harris with a giveaway bump on Carl Krauser. Illinois blowing away Cincinnati today. Vanderbilt with a mild upset of North Carolina State. Kansas being given a very difficult time by Pacific. We've seen in the second round that you just never know.
Well, we're getting down to 32 teams, Tim, and it's going to point out where there may not be an upset left in the field. That's how close most of the teams are.
Brown, not there. Good defensive sequence by Wisconsin.
I mean, going forward, would any win really shock you?
No.
In the tournament?
No, not really. I tell you, Wilkinson has just not been the factor today that one would have anticipated. Krauser with another rebound. Only 4 points in the game for Mike Wilkinson. Krauser tried to force that one into Taft. Not a good decision.
I think this team can survive without Mike Wilkinson being a factor. They can't survive without the guy with the ball right now, Devin Harris, being a factor.
Zach Morley has, in some measure, taken up the slack for Wilkinson's lack of productivity. And at least there with the dribble, he's fouled. He's attracting a lot of attention now from Pittsburgh. It's a 1-1 time. We're in the bonus the rest of the way. There you see the numbers for Mike, averaging just over 13. The thing about him, though, is he can score in bunches, as he did against Richmond the other night. It took them a while to find him, to find Mike in that game. Probably at about the 10-minute mark of the second half, he ignited.
And outside of Devin Harris, what the other players from Wisconsin, what they're good at is letting the offense find them.
Yeah.
Very few of them punt the basketball or punt scoring opportunities. They wait for things to present themselves and then take them. Very few forced shots for the other players.
Morley gets them both. Badgers by one.
10 lead changes in this game. Antonio Graves looking to find Taft, decides to drive. And with Troutman out of the game and with Krauser out of the game, Page is your number one option. Off the bounce. Not there. Did not hit. Well, they did give him credit for the run.
No.
Oh, they're going to say it was a shot clock violation. They reset the clock on the drive, but it did not hit the rim.
No, good call. That one never got up to the basket.
Timmy Higgins quickly went over to the scorer's table to make sure that that horn should have sounded. Nice piece of officiating by a guy that's been in a number of Final Fours.
Do you have the right truck? The best-selling half-ton regular and extended cab is now available as a crew cab. Introducing the new Silverado half-ton crew. It's the right truck from Chevy. Like a
rock. Oh, hey, stop that guy. Hey, help me, somebody. My wallet. Hey, stop. Come here. Hey, stop him. Hey, you.
People aren't used to getting money.
Gave me money.
But once they do, they like it. Move your mutual funds to E-Trade Securities, the one place that rebates half of 12b1 fees. If you get on the same mutual funds and get cash back every year, why on earth wouldn't you? Call 1-800-ETRADE1 or visit etrade.com.
Can't believe you said that.
So you've been sharing a wireless phone?
Really?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
My turn.
Here you go. So you can see the problem.
And I have the solution.
Why share phones to save money? Right now, get a Sprint PCS Vision phone for $29.99. Plus, get unlimited night minutes starting at 7 p.m. on new service plans. Sprint PCS.
At the Bud Light Institute, we're proud that our beer is made with all natural ingredients and is low in carbs. So few, in fact, it's easy to burn the carbs in one Bud Light. That's why we've created the Mini Treadmill 2010. Use your treadmill at home, on the town, even in the gym. And it stores conveniently away till you need to use it again. Order yours today. Fresh, smooth, real. Bud Light, it's all here.
Greg Gumbel in New York with a scoring update in Kansas City. The Jayhawks being outshot by Pacific, but lead them by 4 in Columbus. The Blazers still with a lead on Kentucky by 10. Let's go back to Milwaukee.
All right, Greg, and here a defensive battle between the Big Ten Badgers and the Big East Panthers.
I tell you, I think of Mike Anderson, the job he's done at UAB. Mike, Nolan Richardson would be proud. The Razorbacks back in the day would give Kentucky all they wanted.
40 minutes of you-know-what, yeah. Defensively cut out of that same mold.
He's taking that right into Birmingham, Alabama, as Mike Anderson. 7:20 and counting. Trying to get Wilkinson involved offensively.
Count it, and a foul. That may be great news here in Milwaukee for the Badger faithful.
Chris Taft has had all sorts of troubles guarding out on the perimeter against Wisconsin's bigs, and that's just a great dribble drive and a pump fake inside by Mike Wilkinson.
You got to figure at some point Bo Ryan looks around, and coaches have a tendency to look at the box scores and say, you know, we just need to get this fella more involved in the offense.
And he had the whole left side of the floor cleared out as well. They really gave him an opportunity to maneuver.
Wisconsin by 4, and again, better than 18,000 and 15,000 plus are Badger fans rise to their feet.
The low scoring game, each possession gets magnified, especially against a good defensive ball club.
Krauser against Harris, driving, the help came from Wilkinson, and Harris now tries to take it the distance. Over Page, rebound to Troutman. Numbers the other way, 4-on-1 for Jerron Brown.
Oh, a nice solo count it and a foul, a big time play.
You know the difference in the two plays, Tim, the Harris a little out of control, tried jumping in the air to buy the foul. Jerron Brown came to a 2-foot stop, had his base underneath him and went up strongly. Watch this move. What a crafty little move inside, going with the left hand, just going right around Wilkinson.
That's one of those street moves by a gentleman from Lexington, Kentucky. You know, he was originally going to play for Rick Pitino at Kentucky, and then when he decided to opt to coach elsewhere at the next level, he wound up at Pittsburgh. That ended a 17-6 run over the last 9 minutes. A wily, cagey veteran move by Jerron Brown. In the overplay, Trautman knocks it away. He's already got double-figure rebounds today. Jamie Dixon's team filled with a number of role players that know exactly what their contributions have to be.
Well, the one thing they all do is bang defensively, and that time Trautman did a nice job of fighting Morley off the low block and forcing him out.
Morley with a free baseline. Short arm that one just a bit. Pulled down by Page and out to Trautman. Browser a pull up. A little too strong.
I think he surprised his teammates. No board coverage right there. I think you need to survey it if you're a point guard, Tim, and see that there are better opportunities. He's only 3 of 12 in the game. If he's seeing a bigger basket, maybe that's a better shot.
Generally, his decision making is far better than that. Hansen. He rattles it home. And again, Wisconsin asserts itself. They lead by 4. Taft. Down on the blocks. The freshman can't get it done. There's Jerron Brown again, but this time he is pushed. It'll go against Hansen.
Here's the look inside. Hansen getting a clean look, and you can't afford to give him that type of opportunity. Just under 40% from 3, but down the other end, he was unable to keep Jerron Brown off the offensive glass.
Well, Zach Morley checking out of the game makes Wisconsin a much smaller team. Wilkinson the tallest on the floor.
And I think Hansen in that situation, you've almost got a face guard to keep him off.
Taft with the follow. What a big time flush by the freshman.
Offensive rebounds killing Wisconsin right now.
A steal by Page. Every time a team gets a lead of 4, the other returns to sender.
Just both teams mentally tough, but I think that Wisconsin is the team that's been a little casual with the ball and turnovers here in the second half in the half court.
First one to 60 wins. That's a double. Walk took an extra step, moving that pivot foot, the 11th turnover committed by the Badgers.
Here's what, when you throw a long lateral pass like that against this team, you are begging for it to be picked off. Julius Page, just nice anticipation.
Harris has had an outstanding day, Mike, but he has turned it over 5 times. Trautman off the feed. Yes, and a foul.
Siobhan Trautman just working over Devin Harris. That's a size mismatch down in the low post. Pitt recognizes it.
Well, they cannot go too long without Zach Morley. They went small and they got burned.
Here's the look. That was actually Ray Nixon inside. Either way, Siobhan Trautman too good in the low box to make that play.
He has been outstanding today. After a 9-0 run by Wisconsin, a 7-0 spurt in the last minute 15 for Pittsburgh. 9 points and 13 boards for Siobhan Trautman. That Chevy has been outstanding down low. Boo Wade fouled on the move to the hoop. Looks like Tim Higgins has spotted
Carl Krauser, and that's his fourth.
That's an important foul to give up.
See the look down low, and this is a nice play. Put some pressure on Krauser. And Tim, if I'm Wisconsin now, understanding that he's got four fouls, come back and attack him the next time down the floor. Make him defend.
Foul difficulty now becoming a factor as you see Krauser leaving the game with four. Jerron Brown with three. Taft has three for Pittsburgh. Boo Wade with four, and Mader, who's really not been that much of a factor offensively in the game for Wisconsin, has three.
And with Carl Krauser out now, look for Jerron Brown to be the guy they turn to run the offense.
Let's take a look at our CBS Sportsline stat of the game. And it's three-point shooting, a big, big factor today for the Badgers. Get complete tournament coverage, CBSSports.com. 51-50. Krauser sits. Antonio Graves is in for him. All of Krauser's fouls have come here in the second half.
Jerron Brown always good with that lob. This time Taft couldn't come away with it, and Morley recovered.
He got caught too deep that time in the baseline to make the catch.
Another turnover. That's the sixth on Devin Harris today. Pittsburgh with a one-point lead at crunch time.
Great teams are often forged over the hot coals of adversity. On the eve of the big meeting, the third quarter numbers suddenly changed. But so did your presentation, automatically. You have the new Microsoft Office system. It's a Cinderella story.
We need a car.
A sports car.
A wagon.
Silver.
And certified pre-owned.
That one.
AutoTrader.com lets you compare 2.1 million new, used, and certified pre-owned cars to find the one you want.
Oh, now we gotta sell our car.
I need a car!
AutoTrader.com. Your car is waiting.
I can't believe you said that.
So you've been sharing a wireless phone?
Really?
Yeah. Excuse me.
My turn.
Here you go. So you can see the problem.
And I have the solution.
Why share phones to save money? Right now, get a Sprint PCS Vision phone for $29.99. Plus, get unlimited night minutes starting at 7 p.m. on new service plans. Sprint PCS.
Why do we work? Why do we get up every day and go to work? Because we make things, fix things, send our kids off to learn things. At the Principal Financial Group, we know you don't just work to retire, you work to live. That's why we give people the financial tools to help them keep more of the money they make and do more with the money they save. You work hard, we make work hard for you. The Principal Financial Group, we understand what you're working for.
Wednesday on CBS, Survivor is on a special ad. What's gotten into the All-Stars that's making them so wacky? Don't miss Survivor All-Stars on a special night Wednesday at 8, 7 Central on CBS, America's most watched network. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, Heather Cox. You look at our game reset. Interesting to note that Wisconsin will shoot two at the free throw line the rest of the way while the Panthers get the 1-1.
And in this close game, Tim, does Pittsburgh's free throw shooting woes become an issue? Only 64.8% as a team on the year. Decided advantage for Wisconsin in that category.
Jerron Brown has been a major factor during the second half, and with Krauser's foul difficulty, he needed to be. So has Taft. Much more active today than he was in the opening round. Shot clock at 7. Krauser's to take, gets the bump, and we'll get to the line.
And Tim, he had to be really selective there. Krauser could not afford to pick up an offensive foul on his fifth. But he was able to kind of hedge a little bit and get Wilkinson to commit on the little bump.
He got the mismatch he wanted.
Well, and you know, a big's not going to flop on you in that situation, not going to take a dive, so he's probably not going to pick up the offensive foul.
It's not uncommon to see Karl Krauser get a number of rebounds. But today, particularly in the first half, he was all over the glass.
Seven in the first half.
It's that free throw line that can really be a problem down the stretch, particularly
that was a shooting violation. But if you're in a 1-1, missing the front end could be disastrous for the Panthers. Wilkinson, a pull up, and he's fouled. Taft will get it. That's number four on the freshman.
It's the second time now that they've given Wilkinson that side to clear out, but they did it on a two-man game on the screen roll with Harris.
If you're thinking overtime too, Mike, it would be a disadvantage to have both Krauser and Taft playing with four with this much time remaining in regulation. A reminder, the winner of this game will go to East Rutherford, New Jersey to play Oklahoma State. I thought it was wonderful what Julius Page said to us yesterday. He said, hey, so what if we have to play here? East Rutherford's close to home for us. We just need to get there.
Right. Well, how about if Pitt hangs on and wins, the only bracket where 1, 2, 3, and 4 seeds would hold serve through.
Badger fans want to stop. Page runs right into a double team and turned it over. Julius had made up his mind to take it to the rack.
And when you do that, bad things happen to him. You've got to read what the defense is giving you, what's out in front, and Julius Page did not do it on that particular play.
Four quality options, but that's number one.
Taft the rebound.
Same two-man game, but Devin Harris tried to take things into his own hands.
Look at that. 10 lead changes. Largest lead, 7. 10 ties, 11 changes, actually.
Harris has been quiet, only 6 points in the second half.
Well, you knew the adjustment was going to be made, and it was. Krauser again with the clock winding down. And Harris checking him this time. Now he gets the switch to Wilkinson and takes it to the glass. Beautiful play and great recognition. 14 in the game.
And no call again. Bodies flying everywhere. Krauser taking on the whole Wisconsin front line.
Saw that switch with Wilkinson, and then he made his decision. So many guards could learn a lot from Karl Krauser and his decision-making process.
Morley looking to set the pick for Bouway.
Nice duck under. And again, Morley with the tap out to Harris. The iron unkind pulled down by Troutman.
You know, I think it flashed through his mind to take it out and reset it, but he saw he had a good look from three.
Timeout coming by Jamie Dixon. Panthers clinging to a 2-point lead. Playing in Wisconsin, the Cheeseheads want some more scoring.
Can't believe you said that.
So you've been sharing a wireless phone?
Really?
Yeah. Excuse me.
My turn.
Here you go. So you can see the problem.
And I have the solution.
Why share phones to save money? Right now, get a Sprint PCS Vision phone for $29.99. Plus, get unlimited night minutes starting at 7 p.m. on new service plans. Sprint PCS.
Our game reset. A possession arrow would go to Pittsburgh, and as many scrums as we've seen, that's a vital stat down the stretch, Mike.
Wisconsin really in much better shape timeout-wise. A full complement, 4 left, only 1 for the Panthers.
The play of Troutman and Taft inside has been outstanding for the Panthers, and Zach Morley has just been playing an intelligent game all afternoon long for Wisconsin. Krauser fell. He got the timeout. Very smart play again.
Had he moved one inch in any direction, it would have been a travel.
But that's the last one that Pitt has. He had to burn it on a play where he fell or slipped coming around the screen.
If he rolls over with the ball, it's Wisconsin ball. That's all he could do.
People aren't used to getting money, but once they do, they like it.
Give me money?
Move your mutual funds to E-Trade Securities, the one place that rebates half of 12b1 fees. If you could own the same mutual funds and get cash back every year, why on earth wouldn't you? Call 1-800-ETRADE1 or visit etrade.com.
Roundup knocks out weeds in 24 hours. The leading imitator doesn't. Roundup Fast Act Foam knocks out weeds in 24 hours.
Hey! Now at TGI Fridays, two eat for $19.99. Enjoy an appetizer and two entrees from Friday's special menu. Hurry in for two eat for $19.99. Now at TGI Fridays.
Two teams that clearly have aspirations of making it to the Final Four, just trying to squeeze out a chance to get to the Sweet 16.
Let's see, 13 seconds on the shot clock, no timeouts, ball, you got to get the ball in first. Krauser has had a lot of luck running the high screen roll at the top.
Krauser again with the time winding down, got a pick from Page. Kieron Brown, another rebound on the offensive boards. Five offensive rebounds for him, and he's fouled by Wade.
If Pitt hangs on, Bo Ryan has to look no farther than the offensive rebounding category for the Pitt Panthers in this game, the reason why they've been able to forge into a little bit of a lead. They've chased down a ton of misses in this game.
And he's going to make Brown, a 64% free throw shooter, think about that opportunity at a 1-1.
Somebody once said, everyone will get 15 minutes of fame. Some insurance companies seem to think that that's all you need. But at Allstate, they think 15 minutes may not be enough. That's why they'll take as much time as you need so you can make sure your insurance coverage is right. You deserve more time in the spotlight. That's Allstate Stand. Are you in good hands?
Kieron Brown will be at the line for a 1-1, 64% free throw shooter. His work on the offensive boards has been nothing short of remarkable.
And he's really done a nice job anticipating, lurking along the baseline, able to get position.
One and one.
Didn't look like a 64% shooter right there. Senior stepping up. 24 years old. A lot of maturity on the line.
And that was the ninth team foul committed by the Badgers. So Pittsburgh will shoot two the rest of the way in the double bonus. Winner of this game advances to meet Oklahoma State in East Rutherford, New Jersey next week. Now a two possession game. Harris. With Brown shading him. Morley working over McCarroll. Not there. Wilkinson, a big rebound. Rejected by Trotman. Time winding down. Boo Wade. It was Freddie Owens that hit the three in Spokane last year to bring back the Badgers against Tulsa. Boo Wade, who was the star of the first half in the opening round, hits that three to give the Badgers one last chance.
The new Colorado Z71 with an available 220 horsepower engine.
You're it.
Don't let all that power go to your head. Chevy, an American revolution.
56-55. Obviously, keep away for Pittsburgh, and Wisconsin's got a foul.
Well, and no timeouts, remember, for Pitt, too. They must get the ball inbounds. You must present yourself as a receiver. Give Jerron Brown some outlets.
A lot of times when you're looking for the foul, you'll see steals off inbounds passes. Krauser comes away with it. Harris did go for the steal. Hansen picks up the personal.
That's a good job of getting the ball. That Jerron Brown knew he wanted to deliver to his point guard, who's a 78% free throw shooter.
Regardless of what happens with these free throws, Wisconsin will have a possession to tie the game at the very least. Krauser, after going 6-for-8 today, is inched that number up to 79%. But with 20 ticks remaining, a lot on the line with these.
Now the decision to make on with 20 seconds left. If he makes this one for the three, do you try to get the quick two and extend the game with a poor free throw shooting team?
Not at home. They'll have to get a three. Unless, of course, they decide to take it to the rack, and they don't. They're going to set up a three for Harris. Hansen in trouble. Morley takes the two, does not get it. And the rebound to Jerron Brown, quickly fouled with 3 seconds left. A little indecision that time.
No, yeah, Jerron Brown did a nice job really bodying Devin Harris. And it was weird. It was deathly quiet in here. It's like they were giving their team room to concentrate on that play.
Pittsburgh took away option number one, and then there was confusion.
Benefits of tax deferral, it's always the right time to open an IRA. Call 800-345-5063 to open your no-load, no-fee IRA today.
Just a free throw separates Pittsburgh from the Sweet 16 in East Rutherford, and a matchup against Oklahoma State. Devin Harris and the rest of this Wisconsin Badger team coming up a bit short in that last offensive sequence.
You and I yesterday talked to Jerron Brown and Carl Krauser, Julius Page, to talk about the mental toughness of coming in here and trying to win this game in hostile territory.
Those problems at the line, though, 65%. He did hit his last two prior to that miss. Still hope in Milwaukee. Not one of them, and that should do it. Length of the floor for Harris. Out of bounds to Pittsburgh.
You know, Tim, a low-scoring game, but a terrific college basketball game.
.5 remaining, and the Pittsburgh Panthers have done it. They're on their way to East Rutherford for the Sweet 16. A date with the Cowboys of Oklahoma State awaits Jamie Dixon. Our Chevrolet most valuable players of the game, Devin Harris with 21 on the day, 7 of 14 shooting, and Carl Krauser down the stretch playing with 4 fouls, 16 and 8. For Mike Jaminski and Heather Cox, Tim Brando, happy to be here in Milwaukee this week, and you see as Pittsburgh advances.
All right, Tim, thank you. So the Pitt Panthers, averaging just 56 points a game, win 2 games in Milwaukee. Off we go to Columbus. Kentucky with the lead on UAB. Dick Enberg and Matt Dukas.
The same Columbus, Ohio.